Good morning, students. Today we are going to start our second class of economics. So second class of economics is all about the national income accounting, right? It's a macroeconomics part. And in this topic, we are going to study the circular flow and the basic concepts of the economics, right? Economics is all about the in two parts. That is, the one is the micro and another one is the macro. And economics, in the macroeconomics, is all about the study of national income accounting, determination, government budget, money and banking, and balance of payment. So in the very beginning, I already told you that macroeconomics is a part B section, and here the main topic is national income accounting. National income accounting is a numerical based chapter, right? And now CBSE gives you an opportunity that you have to choose whether to opt for numerical and for theory. So it's up to you, right? So our second topic is national income accounting, and the subtopic is circular flow of income. What is circular flow of income? So circular flow of income is all about the concept of real flow and the concept of money flow, right? What is real flow and what is money flow? Real flow and money flow, here real flow means the transaction between firms and households. Here is the transaction between firms and household without money. What do you mean by the transaction without money? Actually, household is going to provide factors, services to firms, right? And for this, firm will give goods and services to the household, right? Real flow means exchange of goods and services between household and the firms, like a barter system. And money flow means the involvement of money. If household will provide factor services like land, labor, capital and entrepreneurship to the firm, so in return, firm will give rent, wages, interest and profit to the household, right? And when firm will provide goods and services to the household, then it's a duty of household to give the payment of that goods and services to the firm. So when money involved, then it is called money flow. And when there is only goods and services, the exchange of only goods and services, then it is called as the real flow, right? So in detail, now here are the two things. The one is firm and the another one is household. So here I'm going to teach you the basic concepts of real flow with the help of the diagram and the graphical presentation. So this is the concept of real flow. Here it is firm and here it is household. The firm belongs to all type of industries and the household belongs to the household sector. Now, what household initially give to the firm, that is factor services. Okay, so remember this word, factor services, and it is of four types. Number one, land. Number two, labor. Number three, capital. And number four, entrepreneurship. Right? And for this, firm provides goods and services. Goods and services. So here it is clearly given, there is no money involved. I repeat, here there is no money involved, and you have to draw this type of diagram, but in a simple way, not in a graphical way. So in a simple way, what household provide to firm, that is factor services, and what firm provided to household, it's a goods and services. So it's a simple concept. Household gave firm factor services. With the help of factor services, firm produces goods and services and give back to household. Now this is the concept of real flow. In the second way, we are in a category of money flow. This is the firm again, and this is the household. And here, firm and household. Now, in return of goods and services, now it's a time to pay money. Household will provide payment of goods and services. You remember, initially firm gives goods and services to the household. Now in return, firms will get payment of goods and services from the side of household. And what firm will give it to the household? Now firm is going to give it to the household the payment of factor services. Right, students? So here it is, the complete concept of money flow and the complete concept of real flow. Okay? So just revise, practice a lot, draw the diagram, and in the next class, I'm going to teach you the another concept of national income accounting, and all the concepts are really very important, because here we cover only those concepts which will definitely come in the board examinations. Right? Okay. Take care. See you in the next class.